We have noted automotive photographer, probably the greatest automotive studio photographer in the world, Michael Furman here. And Michael, of course, is a Philadelphian and has been involved with Fred and the cars and the collection and the museum forever. In fact, I first heard about Fred from Michael Furman at the Philadelphia Vintage Grand Prix in 1995. And Michael has gone on to, do several books with Fred, including, the beautiful Spirit of Competition book that has all of the cars in the collection with Michael's beautiful photos and Fred's beautiful words. So, Michael, tell us about Fred and what he meant to you and what you meant to him and, your relationship.
Well, Fred was truly an extraordinary vehicle. Listen to me. He was truly an extraordinary individual. And I say to myself, I'll never meet anybody quite like him again. I'll never meet anybody better than him, which is not a cause to be sad. It's a cause to be happy because he was so extraordinary. Fred was the finest human being I've ever met. And on every single level you could imagine. And he cared more about everybody than he cared about himself. I first met Fred when he operated on my back and eventually my neck as well. But whenever I would walk into the museum, I would make sure I was walking properly, that I wasn't hunched over, that I wasn't leaning to one side. Because no matter how far away Fred was, he knew there was something not right with me. And he would chew me out about it. And there's never been another person like Fred, and there never will be another one. And I've kind of made it my life's mission to let people know that how well-respected he is in the car world. It doesn't come close to the level of respect he deserves as a doctor. He was the real deal. And I would, no matter what my situation was, I'd see him and I'd feel better. And he always took great interest in me. He always wanted to know what I was doing. Whenever I came into the museum, he'd make me sit with him and tell him what was going on. And I cherished those moments. And I have to say, not a day goes by that I don't think of Fred. There's not a day goes by that I don't say to myself, well, what would Fred do in this situation? Because I know whatever Fred would do would be right. He was just really, really, really special, special human being. Very special. I'll never forget him. And I don't think anybody else will who's ever met him.
Well, thank you very much, Michael, for your kind thoughts. And we hope to see you again at the museum very soon.
I'm there all the time. It's my favorite place.
Thank you, sir.
Take care, Harry. Okay. Bye-bye. See you.